So it's that time of year again, where the age-old tradition of Black Friday rears its ugly head. Well, I say tradition. In the UK, it's only been going on for 2 years, after the idea was brought across from America. Yet every bloody media outlet talks like it's been going on as long as Valentine's Day, Christmas, or that holiday where we burn a man at the stake. The thing is, I have underpants older than this tradition. So why is this such a big thing all of a sudden? Well, it seems 2014 was a pivotal moment for Black Friday in the UK, as we were treated to barbaric scenes up and down the country of people queuing, fighting, being trampled on, and clinging onto TV sets. All the while being accompanied with the captivating chants and dance routines from a scantily clad cheerleading troupe. Yes, a fucking cheerleading troupe. It's basically like hiring a marching band to entertain the crowds during the annual purge. Now, these kind of violent scenes are nothing new. Black Friday has been going on in America since the early 2000s, but the anarchy has got so bad recently, it's easy to lose count of the damage it does. Except it isn't, because someone has kindly created BlackFridayDeathCount.com, a site which lists all the deaths and injuries caused by Black Friday. That's right, 7 deaths and 98 injuries since 2006, one of which was in the UK last year. And apart from the obvious price drop, it's hard to understand what possesses people to queue up outside in the freezing cold to then partake in a battle royale over electricals. After last year's event, many people tried to make a quick buck by selling their TV on eBay, only to realise that no sane person wants to buy a Blaupunkt TV. Yes, Blaupunkt. You know, the company that makes car stereos? The stereo that a 17-year-old you thought would cause you to be drowning in pussy if you had one in your beat-up Vauxhall Corsa. I don't think the same could be said about their poorly made budget TVs. So who's to blame? Well, Asda was the main instigator of all of this and was quite proud that they were the ones bringing Black Friday to the UK. But after the havoc of last year's events, head of Asda merchandising Andrew Moore said that they had a lot of learning to do and that they will make Black Friday as safe as possible for customers in the future. Which, to their credit, they have made it safer by cancelling all the events across their stores for 2015. But that's good news, right? The company behind Black Friday turning their back on the event? Well, no, because off the back of last year's antics, all these retailers have confirmed they will be holding their own Black Friday sales. So unfortunately, just like Madonna, Black Friday is most likely here to stay. Another bit of American culture that nobody in the UK asks for or wants to see on their local high street. But how about you apply the same Black Friday deals to things other than electronics? Christmas is the season of giving, and with over 1 million people using food banks in the UK, surely you could apply the same deals to groceries. Think about it. If supermarkets took 50% off a Blaupunkt TV, why not take 50% off groceries for a day? Thinking about it, I suppose people fighting over food like in Tesco earlier this year may look like depressing scenes normally reserved for when aid is sent to third world countries. Oh yeah, you wouldn't want that. That's bad PR. Let's just stick to people doing the same over electronics, shall we?